Welcome to Amberger Smackdown at todaysfinancialnews.com. I'm J. Christoph Amberger. A few weeks ago, a kindergarten in Cologne, Germany made it into the news. A mother had been invited to a conference with one of the educators. The reason? Her kid's politically incorrect lunch. You see, this German mother sending her German child to a German kindergarten in what is still Germany put salami on the sandwich. Salami that might be made with pork. And that's the problem. Muslims consider pork bad for the soul. Her son's lunch sandwich thus might offend Muslim kindergartners' sensibilities. The kindergarten would have to insist that the pork-packing parent cease and desist from sustaining her child with un-Islamic foods. As scurrilous, or heck, as mind-bogglingly stupid as this incident might appear, it is by no means isolated. Politicians not just in Europe, but also in the White House, bent over backwards to mollycoddle and assuage Islamist sensitivities incensed by Danish cartoons depicting Muhammad. Since Muhammad is the most popular name in the Islamic world and the second most popular name for newborns in Britain, I've often wondered why offense is taken at cartoons when the majority of men named Muhammad end up looking less than divine all by themselves. Earlier this year, a Paris court convicted and fined former film star and animal rights activist Brigitte Bardot for provoking discrimination and racial hatred by criticizing Muslims' ritual slaughter of sheep. By exploiting the West's libel laws, Islamists have been very successful intimidating writers and cowing publishers who expose terrorist activities, using European courts to silence those who get in their way. Now, Europeans do not have the right to free expression, at least not in the same way as Americans do. By and large, they're even proud of that, believing firmly that spineless acquiescence is the hallmark of truly cultured, multicultural tolerance. But even some Americans seem overly eager to rid themselves of basic rights for the sake of seeming inoffensive. And I'm not talking about the NSA listening in on your son's cell phone call asking you to pick up pizza on your way home from the office. It took New York State's legislature to pass the Libel Terrorism Protection Act to protect authors who are successfully sued for defamation in countries that do not have the same free speech rights that are guaranteed by the U.S. Constitution. Western civilization appears eager to commit assisted suicide by allowing monolithic religious intolerance to smother it with its own pillow. Hopefully, there may yet be a few politicians left who are willing to stand up for Western values and principles. For today's financialnews.com, I'm J. Christoph Amberger.
Okay, good. So, which commodities should investors focus on?